Soon I learned that she scared the bartenders and the room attendants, but they had come to love her. So I wonder, what is it about this soup? She certainly loved her room regulars, as she called them, and they loved her back. She met many HBCs with a big hug and, "Oh, hi, sweetheart." She would make sexy, sultry gate change announcements. And serenade us on the PA after hours with her songs. Celia usually knew when management was about to come into the club because it would always coincide with her snacking at the computer. No change! It seemed as if Marcus rose up from the floor behind us. She marked a big M with tape on the carpet behind us. When Marcus would rise up, we'd hear Celia say, "Busted." She referred to the tea management office as the room with no windows. She'd say, "Well, girls, I've been called into the room with no windows again." It wasn't long before Celia opened up to me. She told me one time, "You know, Judy, I think I might drink too much wine." "But who doesn't?" And then she said, "Well, Lulu." She was like a box of chocolates. We never knew what we were going to have. We will miss you terribly, Celia. Now that you are on the other side, rest in peace. But not for too long. You're too feisty.
I had a lot of great Celia stories. Some are not good for this time, but we shared a lot. We talked heart to heart, and a lot came out. Just trying to help each other, just walk this life, live it to the best of our abilities.
God is able. God is able. God is able, and He won't fail. God is able. God is able. God is able, and He won't fail. Tell me who can move the mountains out of my way, and who can perform a miracle with the seed of my faith? And when the doctor says no, who can still say yes? And when I'm in trouble, who can help me stand the test? God is able. God is able. God is able, and He won't.
So I'm gonna give a few words on my plate. My performance leader came and told me that day when I was at work, it hurt me dearly. I was with my co-worker, Michelle Wheaton. And I told her it hurt me a little dearly because I knew I was supposed to obey that inner voice, and I delayed. Some people may say what I feel, they have their own aspects and agendas, but it was actually genuine love because I knew I loved her, and I knew she loved me back. So for all of you all who talked to her and spoke to her and was there and helped her, and many of you all were there, it was appreciated and it was greatly needed. So I go back to this. Whoever claims to love God yet hate his brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love their brother and sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. When we went to the service this Saturday, we had a lot of people from Delta, not just the Sky Club. And Mr. Brewer got up and he began to speak, and he began to talk about their history, and he began to talk about Celia's history, and we had some laughs. But he was deeply moved by this Delta family that Celia always talked about. And like he said, listen, I just saw it as a basic thing that most people look at. You know, you work with people, you just naturally call them your family. He said when him and his wife came up here to look out, to see what's going on with Celia, to look and see, make sure that everything was okay, he said he saw a whole host of Delta agents, and it made his heart move. And he began to understand what she meant when she kept talking about this Delta family. She called us family. And even down when we went to the reception hall, we began to eat, which was some very good food. Oh my goodness. I told him I'm coming back. He said, take your plate. I said, I'm going to do that too, but I'm coming back. They had some good food. And he began to express to everyone there his deep appreciation, but he made sure he came to every Delta agent and he shook our hands and he began to talk with us. And when it was time to go, Brother Harlow and some other agents were out there speaking with him. And they were blowing the horn, telling us to come on, and we were holding them up. But I reached out and I shook his hand and I hugged him and I said, my brother. And he says, you are my brother. While I'm listening to him crackling in his voice, trying to hold back his tears, with sound confidence and firmness, he said it again, you are my brother. Whoever claims to love God, yet hates his brother or sister, is a liar. Whoever does not love their brother and sister, whom they have seen, cannot love God whom they have not seen. You see, if our love can only extend to the boundaries of our biological fathers, there's a contradiction in our love. If our love can only go to the boundaries of our biological mothers, there may be a contradiction in our love. If our love can only extend to the boundaries of our biological brothers, there may be a contradiction in our love. If it can only extend to the boundaries of our own biological sisters, then there might be a contradiction in our love. If our love cannot extend beyond that boundaries of deep-seated hatred, there may be a contradiction in our love. If our love can only be camouflaged with a smile while you're in my face, but then you reveal who you are behind my back, there might be a contradiction in our love. If our love can only go as far as saying hello and not looking out for our fellow brother, then there might be a contradiction in our love. Love never fails. And I'm asking everybody in here to challenge ourselves to show that genuine love to our brothers and sisters, not just today, but hereafter. And now I'm under no illusion. I know it's going to take some time and work. That's something we have to work at. But it is possible if we're willing to do it. Genuine love never fails. And I'm asking us to make that challenge for one reason. Because regardless of what you feel about Celia, I know that when she said she loved you, it was genuine. Regardless of how you felt about some of the strong passions about some people, I know when she said, my brother and sister, she meant it. So I'm asking us to just challenge ourselves to extend that genuine love to everybody in here, and especially to our brother and sister who have come all the way up here today to be with us. That genuine love continues, and they're showing it right now. So we want to give them appreciation and extend that genuine love, not just today, but to our brothers and sisters hereafter. You never know when we're going to need somebody to help us.
Always energized by our conversations, because as Carlos said, we didn't always agree, but that made the conversation really interesting. When reflecting on my friendship with Celia, several things came to mind, some of which I can't really share. Well, I want to share one funny story. We had this, you know, it was Celia's pet peeve to have too many children in the sky.
Yes. Oh my God.
And so all of us would say, you know, when the summertime came and wicked, we would just call the phone and let Celia just see on the children's screen. But we had this joke. She said, Ed, if I ever have children, what I'm going to do is to bring them to your house, leave them on the doorstep. You show them a picture of me and say, Mommy is never going to
I look to you.